Is it a sin to get a tattoo? Could I still call myself a Christian if I had ink all over my body? Are you a hypocrite for going to church on Sundays and showing off that cool Jesus tattoo that you have on your arm? Hi everyone, it's What's the Word here, and today we're going to take a look at what the Bible has to say about tattoos. You know, the issue of tattoos in the Bible is such a difficult topic to cover because the word tattoo, as we know it today, doesn't actually really appear in the Bible. Now, yes, you may see the word tattoo in some of the English translations of the Bible today, but those translations only included the word tattoo, so that way we could relate a little more to what was going on in ancient times. In fact, the word tattoo, as we know it today, was not actually used until the 18th century. So you aren't going to find any biblical translations before the 18th century that used the word tattoo. But just because there wasn't a specific word in ancient times used to talk about tattoos as we know them today, doesn't mean that it's not a sin, right? I mean, there are a lot of things today that are obviously considered sinful that didn't exist in ancient times. So what are we supposed to make of this? Well, let's take a careful look at Leviticus 19:28, which is the popular verse that people point to that includes tattoos in later translations, just to be safe. Now we're gonna go ahead and read this verse twice. The first time it's gonna be read in the ESV translation, which does include the word tattoo. And it reads, "You shall not make any cuts on your body for the dead or tattoo yourselves. I am the Lord." Now let's go ahead and compare this to the King James Version, which doesn't include the word tattoo. And it reads, "Ye shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks upon you. I am the Lord." Okay, so although the King James Version doesn't have the word tattoo included in this verse, it clearly describes the act of getting a tattoo when it says, "nor print any marks upon you," right? Well, don't jump to conclusions just yet. I've always said that whenever we interpret any part of scripture, we always have to first look at the context. This means that we have to carefully look at the verse and the book where it's from and look at why it was written, when it was written, and who it was written for. Now, in this particular book of Leviticus and in this verse, this law was specifically written for God's chosen people, also known as the Israelites. And this particular commandment was given to the Israelites a little after they were delivered from Egypt, so that way God could separate his chosen people from the rest of the world. In fact, it's widely agreed by theologians that the reason God gave this commandment to the Israelites is because there were surrounding civilizations around the Israelites who were marking their bodies in service to pagan gods. Furthermore, there are other parts of scripture that make it very clear that the Israelites were losing faith during their time in the desert. And because they were losing faith, they often gave themselves into these same pagan practices, such as marking their bodies. So it makes perfect sense why God would give this commandment to the Israelites. God didn't want his chosen people to be aligning themselves with pagan practices. Instead, God wanted his chosen people to be separate and distinct from the rest of the world. But let's just pretend for a moment that we should use Leviticus 19:28 to say that getting a tattoo is a sin. You might even say, well, just like God wanted the Israelites to be separate from the rest of the world, shouldn't we too be separate from the rest of the world? Okay, fair enough. But if you're gonna be using Leviticus 19:28 to say that tattooing is a sin, then that means that you also have to follow the rest of the law that's included in Leviticus as well. So if you're gonna say that getting a tattoo is wrong based on the Old Testament law, then you also have to say that wearing mixed fabrics is wrong, eating well-cooked meat is also wrong, and even just trimming your facial hair is also wrong. That's bad news for me. The Old Testament law was written for Old Testament Israelites. We as Christians are now under the New Testament law, which is written in our hearts, and we are no longer bound by these laws. The fact of the matter is, there is no place in the Bible that specifically says that New Testament Christians cannot get a tattoo. You're not gonna find it anywhere. Sorry, Now, at this point in the video, you might be thinking to yourself, oh, that's great news for me. Right after this video, I'm gonna go to my newest tattoo place, get all inked up everywhere on my body, start looking at some new tattoo ideas that I can make on my sleeves. Not so fast. Although the Bible doesn't specifically say that getting a tattoo is a sin, there are plenty of verses in the New Testament that we need to consider before thinking that this is okay. For example, 1 Corinthians tells us that everything we do, we should be doing for the glory of God. So does getting a tattoo really glorify God? 1 Corinthians also tells us that our bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit and that we should be honoring God with our bodies. So if we get a tattoo, are we really honoring God with our body? The book of Ephesians also tells us that children are supposed to obey their parents. So if you're a child and your parents have told you already that they don't want you to get a tattoo, should you be getting a tattoo? And finally, the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 2 tells us, do not conform to the pattern of this world. So if tattoos are considered a pattern of this world, should we be getting a tattoo? Or maybe some could argue that tattoos are not a pattern of this world today, the same way that they were a few decades ago. The point that I'm trying to make is this. The Bible doesn't specifically say that getting a tattoo is wrong. But the Bible also doesn't specifically say that getting a tattoo is okay either. Unfortunately, the Bible doesn't give us a specific answer on whether or not Christians should be getting tattoos. Personally, I think there's a good case to be made on both sides of the argument. However, there is one verse in the New Testament that always helps me discern between what's right and wrong in tough topics such as this one. And it's found in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 23, which reads, "Everything is permissible, but not everything is beneficial." I love this verse in the Bible because it reminds me that just because there's some things out there that may not be considered a sin, doesn't mean that it's a good idea to partake in. Let's say that there's a recovering alcoholic who spent the last 7 months or so regaining his sobriety, working real hard to turn his life around and renew himself in the name of Jesus Christ, and he's done so well. And then he goes to a family gathering where he's offered just one little sip of an alcoholic beverage. Sure, drinking that one sip of alcohol may not be considered a sin in the Bible. It may be permissible, but for that recovering alcoholic, it is not beneficial. Or maybe there's a student out there somewhere who did not make a wise decision and chose not to study for his test the next day and ended up failing the exam. Sure, there may not be anything in the Bible that specifically says, thou shalt study for your exams. But for that student, not studying for his exam was not beneficial. So this verse tells us that although getting a tattoo may be permissible for us as New Testament Christians, that doesn't necessarily mean that getting a tattoo will be beneficial. For this reason, I want to close with this. If you are watching this video and you really are considering getting a tattoo, but you're not really sure whether or not it'll be beneficial for you, I want to ask you three guiding questions that I hope will help you make the right decision. The first guiding question I want to ask you is this. What is the purpose of you getting a tattoo? Are you getting this tattoo to glorify God? Or is there another reason you might be getting this tattoo? Maybe it's just to fit in with the cool crowd or somehow glorify yourself. Either way, remember that 1 Corinthians 10:31 does say that everything we do should be for the glory of God. So, will your tattoo somehow glorify God, or will your tattoo somehow glorify yourself? The second guiding question that I want to ask is this. Will you feel comfortable having this tattoo on your body for the rest of your life? There are a lot of times when people only think about their present situation when they get a tattoo, and they don't realize that a tattoo could somehow affect them in the future as well. Another way to think of this question is to ask, once again, is this tattoo going to be beneficial for past me, present me, and future me? Or is this tattoo just something that I want right now? The third and final guiding question I want to ask is this. While you are getting your tattoo, can you picture Jesus Christ sitting down next to you and nodding in approval or shaking his head in disappointment? Now, I know that is an intense thing to think about, but it is something that I think can help you make the right decision. Now, there are some people who would argue that no matter what type of tattoo you got on your body, that Jesus Christ would always shake his head in disappointment. But let me tell you this. I remember hearing a story of a man who had a specific tattoo on his body that he really, really regretted having when he became a converted Christian. Every time he would look at that tattoo, it reminded him of the sinful and ugly person that he was in the past. So he decided to go to a tattoo artist and modify that tattoo on his body to represent the new person that he was now in Jesus Christ. Now, every time he looks at that tattoo, he's reminded of his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who rescued him from the bondage of sin and gave him a chance at everlasting life. I can't tell you for sure whether or not getting a tattoo is a sin for us Christians, but I do believe that with a lot of prayer and meditation on God's word and reminding ourselves that everything we do should be for the honor and glory of Jesus Christ, that the Holy Spirit can and will guide you in making the right decision. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. I know that the topic today was a little more controversial, but I want you to know that I really did do my best to research the topic, meditate on God's word, and pray that the Holy Spirit would give me the right words to tell you today. If you are able to take anything from this video, please do me a favor and click the like and subscribe button so that way you can keep up to date with all of the work that we're doing here at What's the Word. I hope that all of you have a wonderful week, and God bless.